As I've already told you, Edwin S. Porter was the one who made this movie called The Big Tin Man. Okay. I'll show you the movie towards the end of the session. Then again, you will understand how storytelling as an art was evolving at that point in time through movies. You know? Movies were no longer restricted to just showing visuals. It had moved to storytelling, as I've already told you. It moved to storytelling. And storytelling became the intent of movie. I was telling you, in the beginning of the class itself, that everything we do tells a story. So the conjecture that a scene doesn't tell a story is wrong. The picture where, you know, the movie where the train was coming inside the Paris railway station, that also tells a story, isn't it? Part of the story, but a story nonetheless. It's a story, right? This is where conventional wisdom takes a backseat. There were stories. The fact is that we could not identify them. And that is why cinema of the 1900s and late 1800s are being moved from new perspective. And that is why we are moving to theme-based movie making now. A lot of these movies that we see nowadays do not tell you an exact story. It's not a boy with skirt and they fall in love and they live after. That kind of story is becoming passé now. We have abstract movies coming. Because somewhere our mindset, our mind, our persona also moves towards abstractism. So anyway, we'll come to that as well. Slowly, but gradually. This is the scene. This is one of the pictures from that movie called The Great Train Robbery. Okay. Which day? Which movie is this from? Citizen Kane. How many of you have seen this movie? Anyone else? Anyone else? You have, you say the right name of the movie.
I know the
name,
sir.
You know the name of the movie. You know, it's considered to be the best movie ever made. Subject to interpretations again, but largely considered to be the best movie ever made. Can anyone tell me who made this movie? A guy called Orson Welles, who was only 26 years old. When he made this movie, he acted and he directed the movie. He himself acted. Now, can you imagine that this guy at that point in time was only 26 years old? He was only 26 years old at that point in time. 1915 born, and it's a 1941 movie. So people who say that now costumes and designing have become very advanced haven't seen Citizen Kane. And I'll show you more of his movies, Orson Welles' movie, and you'll understand what sort of a design they made. Outstanding. And Citizen Kane is considered to be the best movie ever, not for his story, by the way. It's again a mystery movie. It's a question in the beginning of the movie, which is answered at the end. Citizen Kane is considered to be the best movie because of the very structure that it followed at that point in time. Here I'll tell you a story. In the 1930s, there were a lot of controversies about movies coming out in America. A lot of these movies showed kissing, homosexuality, all this stuff. And people are not, you know, comfortable with that at that point in time. See, I'm talking about the 1920s. Even America, as a matter of fact, was a conservative society, a very, very conservative society. It did not have female suffrage. Women are not allowed to vote at that point in time. So we're talking about a society of that time. There's a lot of controversies about that. Like, people were saying, a lot of critics were saying that cinema is destroying society. So the Motion Pictures Association of America, they came up with a code. It's known as the Hays Code. Okay? It was named after this guy called Will Hays. Okay? Now the Hays Code, it says, one, you have to follow unilinear unilinear narrative structure. Two, it has to have an ending where the good guy wins and the bad guy loses. Three, it cannot have a kissing sequence which lasts more than 15 seconds. Four, it cannot have homosexuality. Five, it cannot show divorce in the true sense of the term. A lot of restrictions were there. And this movie was made with all these restrictions in mind. Now we have a lot of independence in movie making, right? We can do anything that we want. It's pretty much everything that we want. But in 1941, those factors are not there. Even under those kind of constraints, this movie was made, Citizen Kane was made. And by the way, it gives you a linear narrative But the storyline is not linear. Anyone who has seen this movie will say that it doesn't have a linear storyline. The narrative was linear, but the storyline wasn't. I'm sure you know. The storyline was not linear. It went back and forth. But this narrative that followed was linear, because the structure was such that. With all these considerations in mind, Citizen Kane was made. And unfortunately, he did not win one single Oscar. Because there were coteries at that point in their movie. Till now it is there. Let me tell you something. Let me give you another fact. It's beyond the point, but you should know this. Alfred Hitchcock never received an Academy Award for Best Actor. Best Director. Stanley Kubrick never received an Academy Award for Best Director. Martin Scorsese received only once, and that too for a remake movie in 2006. Charlie Chaplin never received any Oscar for the Best Director. That gives you an idea how the Academy Awards are biased. So never go by the Academy Awards. The Academy Awards say that this is the best movie. Take for granted that it is not.